some nice thing about the dialogue is that of the view is that, have you seen the group by before? So you can group it, for example, by session, because I don't want to see all the clutter that happened before. I just want to see what has happened in my current session. Or maybe I don't care about all the other crappy plugins, or only about my plugins, of course. So I can arrange it by plugin, and I can see which plugin caused what error. This is pretty nice. Another very powerful view is the plugin registry. Plugin registry evolved over the time. So in the meantime, it's with the PDE tools. The plugin registry. Basically, it lists all of the plugins in the default view. We have more options here. And for every plugin, let's say, for example, the EGIT, we see several details, like what are the exported packages of that plugin, what are the imported packages of that plugin. We see the services used by the plugin, for example, debug options, remember that, we will see that later. We see the registered services, and we see also the extensions. You can do it the other way around. For example, if we go to the Eclipse UI plugin, Eclipse UI contributes most of the extension points to actually build the RCP application. Here are the extension points. We can see who extends these extension points. For example, the commands. Where do all the commands come from? Which plugins do actually contribute commands? Can you see that? Is the 400K in the very back? Can you see that? Perfect. The nice thing about this view again, is you can configure it and you can change the view. For example, you can go to the service view and then you see the services, all the services that exist in the Eclipse workbench and how they are contributed and how they are consumed, which is pretty nice. The same, you can, if you're more from the Eclipse plugin XML dot point of view, you can also go for the extensions and see all the extensions which are here. So you can debug your implementation, whether it nicely fits into the workbench and whether your contributions are available. Okay. Let's go with this one. So we have a lot of some nice short keys. One is the selections by. You probably know that. If you select something with Alt-Shift-F1, you get a detail about what is selected here, who implements that, what is the class, and it's all linked, which is really nice. And here's the selection. So you can directly, for example, click the Explorer part class and you see the source code. So you can explore existing implementations and reverse engineer it. It's all free. It's all with the Eclipse Classic installation. So you don't need to install that. Okay, what else? The menus by. Do you know the menus by? Which is also nice. It's the same combination, F2. You see the cursor changing here? See the and if you click on a menu, let's say a drop-down bar here, a toolbar here, we see who contributes the item, who's responsible for that. Sometimes you have a huge compilation of plugins and you get some weird button somewhere in the user interface which really scares you and you won't understand who contributed that. So you can easily find out what plugin contributes, for example, the new package. Thingy here.
Question.
Yep.
The menus by only works in the IDE or does it also work in any RCP application?
The?
RCP application?
Which one? The?
The menus by.
The menu, I think so, but we can.
So it works.
It does.
It does, it works.
Okay. Some sort of PDE plugin, so you can just.
It's a PDE runtime, or?
PDE runtime.
So I used, this is a plain 4.2 classic with some additions. I'm not sure, but we should find a way how to find out who contributed the shortcut, right? Yeah, we do that tonight in the BOF. How to find out who contributed a shortcut. I don't have a solution for that right now, but we'll find one. The other one which became pretty prominent with the E4 is the control free, which basically lists all the commands or all the contexts available, all the actions available in a particular context. You can type ahead and search for your context. But my favorite is the meta shortcut. Do you know what a meta shortcut is? The shortcut that shows all shortcuts currently available, the control shift L. It's pretty nice. It works in any context and shows all the shortcuts available in that context. So you can debug and see whether the shortcuts actually make sense, which are defined in this context. Sometimes if you're not programming clean with your context, you might mess up your shortcuts and get unexpected entries here. It's pretty common to do that. In the preferences, we have two nice sheets, which sometimes help. One is the keys. The keys is actually there to configure shortcuts, but if you sort them reasonably, so you see all the commands available. And this helps me a lot. For example, reuse one of the common commands. If I want to refresh content, I don't declare my own command. I use existing semantics. So I can easily list all the commands which are defined in a given context in this view. The other one, which typically everybody enables, is the heap status, which gives you a heap, the heap numbers down here. Everybody, I think, activates that to see before the JDT crashes, if you have a huge workspace. Good. So, okay, this is what we get for free. If you do some updates to our target platform, we get nice other tools. Let's have a look at some SWT tools, the SWT Spy and the Sleek. You get it when you install these from the update side, these SWT tools. The SWT Spy basically gives you an ugly looking view, this one, with helpful information. If you activate it and if you move your cursor around, you can always, you see the content changing, you see the exact hierarchy and the exact widgets which are below the cursor, which is very helpful if you, for example, debug layout problems and don't get your widget hierarchy right. So you can look into how the application is assembled. The other thing is in the Eclipse RCP or SWT, you are responsible for resources, right? If you allocate a color, for example, or an image, it's about you to manage the lifecycle. You have to create it, then you have to dispose it. And there's the SWT Leak or Sleek tool. I can't start it right now here. I tell you later why. I need to launch another Eclipse application here. Tell you why. I have to do that later. But just to give you a quick idea about the Sleek tool. Here's the view, I already opened it. And if you press the snap button here, you get a list of all resources that has been allocated by this running instance. So it's runtime inspection. Eh? You get all the colors that has been, and the images, all the images, and you get a nice preview on the right side. And but what's more important, if you check the stack option here, you see the stack trace, where this has been allocated. This is actually not an error. They just use the exception to trace the position. You see in stack trace where this particular resource has been allocated. I have one editor open here. I have another one open here. I can toggle between both. And what I can do here is I can create a diff between two points in time. So what happens with the resources between, for example, opening the one editor and opening the other editor. So I switch back to the other editor and take the diff, and I see like four colors and 21 images has been loaded. I really want to debug that, why that happens. So just toggling between two editors creates 21 images. It's most of the images, if we look at them, are some, I guess, some styling stuff. These are the commands, which probably shortly get disabled and enabled again or something like that, and resources get disposed. I don't know why. I hope the overall number of resources is not increasing with the normal JDT distribution. This is very helpful to get your resources, to manage your resources, and this might be a non-functional test case to observe your application in non-functional testing to make sure the applications, the resources are limited. Okay, why did I start another instance? Because I needed to activate tracing. Tracing is another tool to provide additional, let's say, debug options to your target application. And many, many of the plugins, of the default plugins, have these additional debug options, tracing options. You might have noticed this tab here, the tracing tab. You see all the plugins which support tracing. And in our case, it was the eclipse.ui, and I needed to check debug, and there's another one down here, trace graphics. I needed to check both, and this tells the target to actually trace the resources and track whenever a resource has been allocated. I can use that for my own plugins. We do that. It's pretty easy, actually. If you want to use the same functionality for your plugin, for example, to trace some business functionality or maybe some technical stuff. I have an example plugin here. What you basically do is, I need the name of the plugin, you create a .options file. And it's a property file. And the format is like this, key value. This is the default value. And I save that. And now I start my target application again. And on the tracing tab, I should now get a new entry. And I can now enable this and maybe debug for the next year. So how do I access this information? We enabled it with the options file. We provide at runtime, we provide a debug.properties file with the actual properties to the target application, and we can use it in our code. The old school way to access it is using the static method, platform get debug options. So you can get the debug options for a particular key. The new style way, use services, of course, is there's a debug options service, and if you want to register for changes, if it changes dynamically, you can register the debug options listener with the whiteboard pattern, so you get notifications if one of the debug options changes. Most of the Eclipse plugins actually make heavily use of that, so if you look at the JDT, for example, the compiler, you have hundreds of options to print out every kind of detail in the Eclipse compiler, so if you're want to fix some bug, let's say, in JDT, maybe it's useful to use these options to understand what's going on there.
Is there a way to consume the tracing events themselves?
Unfortunately not. Eclipse lacks of a low-level logging system. And most of the plugins, they do like if, then system out print line. That's what happens.
There's this trace mechanism inside Eclipse, which writes
on
the trace.log file, right?
Basically, that's system, I think, on the console. Most of the plugins simply print on the console. For example, the performancing, and here this happens if you start tracing. You get these basic performance figures. It's all printed to the console, as far as I know. Maybe they have fixed this. So, does somebody know? It's still the console.
Currently about to prepare a contribution for a view that actually prints out this information that's been traced if the trace API from Eclipse is used.
But currently, how does tracing happen to the console, right?
It completely depends on the plugin itself, usually okay. At the console, right?
Okay.
And there's another information, since Juno, there is a UI to dynamically turn on and off this tracing option.
Within the. Is it available by default here? Can I use it directly?
You can use it directly if the plugin registers itself.
Okay.
So there's a little bit of
Okay, so we find out tonight at the BOF how to use that?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. E4. E4, this is already Eclipse 4.2 running here. You have the modeled workbench, so we can look into the E4 model if you install the E4 tools. So you don't get it with the plain Eclipse installation. And then you get some nice new shortcuts, like the Alt-Shift-F9, which gives you the workbench model, which sits behind the user interface. And here you can, first of all, study how everything is built up. And then you can probably like screw up your user interface completely, like remove the toolbar. Should work. Yeah, now it's gone. If you don't like it, you can remove it here. The other nice thing is with Eclipse 4, E4, all the styling, all the user interface is done with CSS, and they have a nice CSS spy to identify the layouting and the style of a particular widget. Let's select the Package Explorer here and open the spy. Now you get the hierarchy, the composite hierarchy, and what styles actually apply to the current selection and how it is applied to SWT. So if you create your own style and it happens to look ugly, you might use this tool. And it also, you see the red sash, which shows you what is the current selection here. It also works for dialogues. This is a nice thing about this. You can also style dialogues in E4. Okay. So, but what I really want to encourage you is to write your own tools. Tools which are specific to your domain, which fit to your customer, which fit. It's very easy in Eclipse. It's very easy to contribute to Eclipse, to your application, and provide specific solutions. I have two small examples for you, just what can be done in a few lines of code. What we use a lot in a huge application at Swiss Railroad is extensions to the properties view. The property view, you can put additional pages there. And what we use a lot is our debug page. It's here. What is this? It's basically like a debugger in the IDE, which shows the object tree based on reflection. If you select something in the workbench, I mean, the debugger pretty much does the same, but it's very hard to identify actually the object. So how do you make the debugger to breakpoint if you select something in the in your business model, your domain model, whatever? In this case, it's the JDT, the Java model. And so you can directly browse it within the within your running application. And this might be very helpful if it's a complex domain object, for example. Let's say insurance applications with hundreds of attributes, so you can understand and debug why the application behaves in a particular situation the way it does. The other thing which is nice is Eclipse, you can use the adapter pattern. And to test the adapters, you might contribute a property page which shows all the adapters which apply to the selection. Here, so here we see what this selection adapts to. And for each adapter, again, we can explore what is the actual implementation and what is the inner structure of this. It's again done with reflection, pretty simple. Another thing, if I need to create a dialogue, let's pick one, let's say the search dialogue. And the dialogue is, let's say, resizable. I always screw up the layouts. So it always, if I do it the first place, it never behaves like that. I get some weird scroll bars at places where I do not expect them. So I added this tool, which is a pretty simple shortcut. I hope I remember. Which does nothing else than color the layout by random colors. And now I see how all my layouts are aligned and whether everything is attached properly. So typically what you do is you miss to set some let's say, grid data, and then it does not align to the right, and so everything gets squeezed to the left and things like that. This is what typically happens. So what I want to encourage is you, if you have some problems, simply contribute additional tools which do not belong to your actual application to make your work easier. I have some screenshots for what I told you about support. Once your application is shipped, also some additions might help your support organization. What is really ugly is the default Eclipse error dialog. The dialog is really useless for end users. So you might improve it. You can hook into the Eclipse and create your own dialog. It might look like this, like, okay, here's some technical problems. So don't bother the user with the technical problems. What do you want to do? Do you want to restart? Do you want to quit? Or maybe ignore it. You might want to, if you're a technical person, you might double click on the entry and see the details. But in the end, out there in the field, I can't do much with the error. So we created an option which says save error report. And what it does, it creates a zip file, which is based on an extension point, a custom extension point, to collect all kind of data. This is a zip file, and it's extension point, and all different kind of plugins, like business plugins, contribute entries to that. It could be, for example, the logging as such, or some version information, all the information that the development team needs to support the customer out there. It might be log files, or might be even the exception that happened here. So we have it right in here. Okay, so time is over. I schedule a BOF for tonight from 9 to 10. I'm pretty sure you have many more ideas like that, and you know many, many more tools which are already there. So I encourage you to come tonight and maybe discuss this, or maybe you have additional questions, how this is done or how this all works. I also encourage you to come tonight from 9 to 10. I think it's after the circus. The circus is till 9. We have like 2 minutes for questions. Any questions? So thank you, and please evaluate the session. And maybe see you tomorrow at Let's Make Some Coffee, Babe, my talk at 3 in the theater tomorrow. Okay, thank you. Hallo.
Ich weiß nicht, kennst du Eclipse Monitor?